subscribe to our YouTube channel Van Fin Multibaggers and press the bell icon to see the latest updates and videos. Van Fin, discover opportunities, create wealth.
Which has gained almost 23% in the last five trading sessions and is currently trading with gains of 3% as well. At least in today's job trade, slightly lower than from its day's high, is still in the green. We have the promoter Sabu Jacob, who has a stake in the company, and let's discuss further in detail as to the outlook of the company in the coming quarters as well, with the managing director who joins us on the phone line. Mr. Jacob, good morning and thanks for joining us. Let me just start off by asking you about the fact that you have received all approvals from Karnataka government and completed a land acquisition for the same when it comes to your projects there.
Yeah, actually, we got the clearance from the Karnataka government for the land. Still now we have to move with a lot of other formalities. And only the problem due to the election in Karnataka, everything is a little slow. But in the meantime, I think Andhra also, we are, doing some research because they are also very much interested for investment. So Andhra government officials came here and, they offered something. And, so we are just working on that. Andhra versus Karnataka, what's the benefit to the company? So we are just, maybe a couple of weeks, we are going to take a decision. Maybe both Karnataka and Andhra, some investment or, some places we will consolidate.
Good morning, Mr. Jacob. This is Shraddha here. I just want to understand how you will split the investment between the Karnataka and Andhra Pradesh facilities, if you've given that a thought. And also for your Karnataka plant, you said there has been some delay with respect to clearances. But by when do you expect to, start commercial production?
See, I mean, as I said, currently, we are working with the Andhra government also. So basically, the ratio will be, based on, what benefits, both the governments are offering. Because now Andhra seems to be very aggressive, inviting investors. So, but there are so many other technicality and, some climatical issues are there. Because, so we have to take a real decision. If we decide to split in the investment, definitely that is based on the, maybe both the operations, some portion 40% here, 60% or 50-50, or it can be 100% in one places. So we are not sure about that.
Sure. Sir, if you could tell us about the kind of tax benefits that are expected from the Karnataka plant once operational versus, what the Andhra Pradesh state is offering.
It's not a tax benefit, actually. Basically, the land cost and electricity and, we gave all the investment plans, both the, to Andhra. So they are, they gave us, some information about, what they have right now. But what they offered me, it's all can be discussed and, negotiated. That means they are more flexible giving us, for example, land price or electricity or whatever it is. So they are more flexible on that.
Right. Mr. Jacob, when it comes to this Karnataka plant, would you be looking to cater to the domestic market or will it be 100% exports or will it be a mix?
Yeah, this is going to be 100% export. We never had any plans to launch, the domestic market. So we are focusing because, we are focusing to the mass production, huge production capacity, maybe per day, like 400 to 500,000 pieces per day. So basically, we cannot market that sort of volumes into Indian market. But we have, very strong market in the U.S., so we are focusing to 100% export-oriented.
Sure. Sir, irrespective of how you decide to split the investment between Andhra Pradesh and Karnataka, how do you plan to fund the acquisition? Fund the expansion, sorry?
See, basically, this 500 crores is not going to be, one stretch. It's going to be like a 3-year plan from, when we start. So we, at present, we think, you know, it's a combination of, you know, internal accrual plus, debt. Because, you know, the government depends based on, you know, the machinery investment. Certain areas, government is giving huge subsidy on the tough scheme. And whereas, you know, we have to utilize, you know, the debt portion. So we are getting straight away, you know, the huge benefit on that. So it's going to be a combination of debt plus internal accrual. Wherever, you know, the benefit, you know, due to the tough scheme, you know, we are going to utilize the debt and, you know, the balance portion, all internal accruals.
Right. Mr. Jacob, you've been buying shares in the open market. Is there a specific plan to increase stake, and is there a specific target as well, perhaps about 55%?
It's not like that, you know. See, we are just, you know, I mean, now, you know, there's a limitation for, you know, promoter's quota. So, you know, we are just, you know, trying to increase our promoter's quota and nothing specific, but, you know, we are trying to, you know, improve our portion.
All right. Just a last question. So the third quarter numbers, of course, were slightly on the weaker side. Just want to understand what the fourth quarter so far has been in terms of, you know, the exports of, since 2 months have already passed.
Right. See, basically, you know, I mean, our fourth quarter is the best quarters for us. You know, if you see, you know, last several years, that's our peak period. So, two areas, you know, one is, you know, the foreign exchange loss as well as, you know, the GST impact, you know, affected our profit on the Q3. But we are trying to make it up, you know, in the Q4. As well as the turnover, as well as, you know, already we know we touched 13% growth as on today, 9 months. But, you know, we are trying to improve the turnover as well as the profit numbers. You know, we are trying to improve, you know, by, you know, making, you know, now dollar is, you know, very good. So basically, I think, you know, it's going to be very good year for us.
Could you give us any sort of a number, or at least, you know, some sort of a target with respect to the FY19 revenue growth and also the margins?
I cannot give the numbers right now, because you can see that, you know, it's a 13% overall growth, you know, 9 months. Definitely that will be much more. And also the profit numbers, you know, as on today, you know, it's something like 22% PBT, 24%, 23%, that definitely we are going to improve.
Right. Thank you very much for speaking with us, Mr. Jacob.
Thank
it
you.
Is a pleasure talking to you. Kitex Garments, up as the management, the stock is holding on firmly to gains up about 2.5% in trade.